Helloing everyone, welcome to my channel UK Immigration and Visa Updates. Today update we will talk about and share with you a latest news about the immigration rules allow people to apply to remain in the UK on the basis of long residence. Those here lawfully can apply for indefinite leave to remain following 10 years continuous lawful residence in the UK. What does continuous mean in long residence applications? Paragraph 276b does not stand alone. Other nearby paragraphs define some of the words and terms used. Paragraph 276a sets out the definition of continuous for the purposes of paragraph 276b. Leaving the UK is broadly permitted as long as the person has permission to be in the UK when he or she leaves. Does not remain outside the UK for more than 6 months at any one time or for more than 18 months during the 10-year period relied on. And has permission to be in the UK when he or she returns. There is one exception to the requirement of having permission at the time of leaving and returning to the UK. The long residence guidance confirms that continuous residence is not broken if someone departed the UK before the 24th of November 2016, but after the expiry of their leave to remain, and applied for fresh entry clearance within 28 days of that previous leave expiring, and returned to the UK within 6 months. Are absences from the UK permitted for long residence applications? Any absence of more than 6 months will break continuous residence, and so will departing the UK in certain circumstances. A break in continuous residence will in effect restart the clock. In addition, the person is not allowed more than 18 months outside the UK in total, which is a period of 548 days. Days of departure and return do not count towards the total. It is only whole days outside the UK which count. The long residence guidance covers some situations which seem to fall outside the rules. For example, the policy states that where there are absences in excess of 6 months at once or 18 months in total, there is little further explanation of when discretion might be exercised, suggesting that it will be rare, but not impossible. I have seen, for example, an application being successful on this basis when we could show that the applicant was outside of the UK for more than 6 months because the Home Office initially refused the application for entry clearance but later reversed its decision. Had it not been for the Home Office's first erroneous decision, the applicant could have returned to the UK within 6 months. One would also hope that an absence of more than 6 months due to COVID-19 would be considered compelling and compassionate circumstances. Certainly, long absences for this reason can now be overlooked as part of a citizenship application, although the long residence policy doesn't explicitly mention COVID-19. Other requirements, in addition to showing 10 years continuous lawful residence in the UK, to have a successful application under these rules, an applicant must show that there are no reasons why granting leave is against the public good. They do not fall for refusal under the general grounds for refusal. They have passed the life in the UK test. They speak English at level B1. They are lawfully resident in the UK at the time of the application, except for any period of overstaying for 28 days or less, which will be disregarded.